Sorry.
Can I ask a question?
Yeah, go ahead.
So you said that if someone, you said that if you said that atheists don't understand it, yeah?
No, so atheists can understand it.
They can't.
They can.
They can.
Yeah, yeah, that's what
so
I said.
Who doesn't understand it?
The people who are arrogant. متكبرون. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran. Those who reject Allah, Allah's ayat. المتكبرون وما يكفر بآياتنا إلا إلا لا لا ضعف بس أمر في دبس صوت غافر ألف لا وما يجحد بآياتنا إلا الظالمون the oppressors and transgressors so those who cannot understand it not because they cannot understand it because they go and guess their sound reasoning and natural inclination because those tools Allah create them with sound however because of arrogance So what stops people from accepting Islam? Either arrogance or i'raad. It's too busy. She's too busy with dunya, you know? I'raad. Or what is it?
You mean Islam as a state of consciousness or as a religion?
As a religion, as the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As a deen, as been to submit to Allah, to worship Him, follow His teaching, yeah, way of life. You know, to be the servant of Allah, to worship Allah according to His teaching. And to worship Allah according to His teaching is only in Islam.
Okay, so you made a very good point because I agree with you on the mutakabbirin part.
Yeah.
And instead of mutakabbir, will never be able to see the truth, and they will never be able to the Quran won't be revealed to him because Allah Subhanahu wa Taala said, "La yamassu illa al-mutahharun." You have to be purified. Your heart has to be purified for you to be able to receive.
But that statement, my sister, may Allah bless you, cannot be utilized. That the mutakabbirun cannot. The truth cannot be cannot come to them because the ayah, if you connect it to before, this ayah talking about Lawh al-Mahfud. It's not talking about the Quran. But even some ulama do use it.
Sorry, what is that?
وَلَا يَمَسُّهُ إِلَّا الْمُطَّهَرُونَ
Yeah.
The ayah is talking about Lawh al-Mahfud.
What's
the preserved tablet. في لوح المحفوظ.
Okay, so who can touch that?
That only the angels.
So.
But even some ulama.
For
some people touched it, Lawh al-Mahfud.
Well, his heart did touch it for him to understand it. And
that's the difference. No. Lawh al-Mahfud is not. Lawh al-Mahfud was not revealed for Prophet. Lawh al-Mahfud is that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has written 500,000 years before. 500 years before. No, خلق الإنسان. Before creation, everything. كان الله ولم يكن شيء معه وكان عرشه فوق الماء.
No, before creation of man.
No. Lawh al-Mahfud. Allah has written every Lawh al-Mahfuz before the creation of everything, not just man. Not just man.
Yeah, before the creation.
Not just of man, just creation of everything.
Everything, yeah.
Yeah, okay. I thought you said man.
Ar-Rahman.
Yeah.
Ar-Rahman, alama al-Qur'an.
Khalaqa al-insana.
Man khalaqa al-insana.
Man alama al-bayan. Nah.
So, but the part I disagree with is that if your statement is right, which is right about the arrogance part, then how do you detect? Because we obviously as Muslims we take our religion or our understanding from previous people.
What do you mean from previous people?
From previous scholars and so on. So.
Inam Quran. That's what our sources. Quran, the Sunnah, and the Salaf al-Saleh, pious predecessors.
How do you guarantee that they did not have some of them who brought us a religion didn't have kibr in their heart?
Because Allah purified them. Allah does not praise the mutakabbirun. And Prophet Muhammad doesn't praise the mutakabbirun.
So who praised the Salaf
al-Saleh? The Nabi said in the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, خير الناس قرني ثم الذين يلونهم ثم الذين يلونهم. The best people in my generation and those who come after them and those who come after them. So Prophet ﷺ said they are the best people. Another narration in Sahih Bukhari.
Three generations.
We know them because why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to agree with me, my sister, that Quran is the last revelation.
It is, yeah.
And this Ummah is the last Ummah. It's the last Ummah, Ummah Islam. Prophet Muhammad ﷺ is the last messenger of Allah. Well, you believe there's another messenger coming?
Yeah, there's messages until the end of times.
No, I guess the Quran. Prophet ﷺ, ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم.
He's not أبا أحد من رجالكم.
ولكن وخاتم.
خاتم النبيين.
Yeah, the list of prophets. There's no prophet.
Yeah, because خاتم النبيين is the last levels of prophecies.
No, it doesn't say that. خاتم الأنبياء. No, خاتم النبيين is not خاتم النبوة or something. خاتم النبيين. خاتم there's قراءتين. خاتم and it's خاتم. There's قراءتين, two recitations. However,
one
no, there's two recitations.
Which ones?
Both of them correct. Because the Quran, from the I'jaz of Quran, The Ijaz al-Qur'an, the Qur'an was... Yeah, that's something. No, no, no. The Iqraat al-Ash, yeah. The different Qur'an.
But the Iqraat al-Ash, I believe, it's accents. It's not how it was revealed.
That's how it was revealed. Allah. So the Qur'an was...
So that's the accents of the way the Arabs used to speak.
No.
It's the accent.
So the Qur'an was not preserved then?
Sorry?
So the Qur'an was not preserved?
It is.
So, but you...
They weren't able to fully... they've only tweaked it a little bit with the harakat and the tashkeek.
No. The Qira'at al-Ashr is a Qira'at goes back to Prophet Muhammad SAW.
No, it doesn't.
So it's been changed.
So it's been changed, yeah.
So Allah said he preserved the Qur'an.
Yeah, that's why Qur'an needs to be revealed to you to be able to see the truth upon you.
To be revealed to you?
Yeah, to be revealed in real life. For example, like if you had...
But Qur'an was revealed to Prophet Muhammad SAW.
Sorry?
Qur'an was revealed to Prophet Muhammad SAW.
Yeah, the Qur'an keeps revealing itself until the end of time.
Where is the proof of the end of Qur'an?
Sorry?
Where is the proof of the end of Qur'an? Where do you get that from?
In the Quran, it says, "Inna anzalna ilayka al-kitab li
lu'min." No, ilayki, ilayka.
Ilayka,
to everyone. No.
This khitab. No, ya Muhammad.
Who is there, mukhatab there?
To anyone who's reading and actually believes the Quran.
So Abu Jahl was reading it, was to him, Abu Jahl.
The Quran is for everyone.
So Allah revealed the Quran to Abu Jahl.
If it wasn't revealed to him, then it wasn't revealed.
No, revealed mean who received the Quran from the Wahl. Allah spoke with the Quran. Ar-Rahman allama ish. Quran. Allama al-Quran to who directly? To who?
Allama al-Quran. What does allama mean? It doesn't mean teach. It means it's embedded in you.
No. Allama, no.
So I'll tell you something. Do you know when someone comes to accept Islam?
Yeah.
Okay. They tell you, oh my God. So, for example, you translate the Quran, yeah? You try to put it into meaning to the person in front of you. They feel tingles. They feel tingles and goosebumps. Why? Because they remember tadakkaru what was actually embedded in them. Because Islam and the oneness of Allah and the fitrah is already there. Because a person when he...
But no, Quran is already there. It's the fitrah which goes in line with the teaching of Quran. But I'm saying to you, no, sorry, sister. Ar-Rahman wa'allama al-Quran. Khalaq al-insan. Yeah, he didn't say Ar-Rahman khalaq al-Quran fil insan. No, allama al-Quran. So that's a refutation that Quran is embodied within us. Allama, he took the Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned the Quran. The ayah subhanAllah. وَإِنَّهُ لَتَنْزِيلُ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ نَزَلَ بِهِ الرُّوحِ الْأَمِينَ عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ لِتَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُنْدِرِينَ بِلِسَانٍ عَرَبِيٍّ مُبِينٍ. No, عَلَىٰ قَلْبِكَ.
عَلَىٰ
قَلْبِكَ. No. Wait.
Doesn't necessarily mean that it's for Muhammad only. Do you know why?
No, it's for everyone.
It's for everyone. No. عَلَى قَلْبِكَ لِتَكُونَ مِنَ الْمُنْذِرِينَ. So I'll give you an example.
عَلَى قَلْبِكَ مَنْ.
Okay, can I give you an example?
No, before
for
sister.
You, for everyone.
No, wait. So the first person the Quran was given to whom?
To Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
خلاص, so first person gave it to whom?
Sorry?
The Quran, before you start learning the Quran, you learn the Quran from who?
You learn it.
So it was not given to you then. You learn the Quran from a book. It's not from your heart.
No.
So therefore, Quran was not given to your heart.
No. The Quran, the alam al-Quran is already in you, but when you read it, it activates.
Sister, No. If the Quran is in my heart, if the Quran is in my heart,
yeah.
If in my heart, I'm more the Quran in me, everyone's half it then.
There's a
muscle
for
muscle.
They say,
"Hafid mishfahim." My sister, what you said is, you have to clarify. Before you give an example, you have to clarify to us what you say exactly.
Okay.
Because your statement, I don't want to accuse of kufr, but can be a kufr statement. Because we know, well established, that Quran was given to Prophet Muhammad SAW directly.
Yeah, I don't disagree with that.
Then Prophet Muhammad SAW taught the Sahaba, then the Sahaba wrote it down. Then they pass it down to us. And prove that the Quran was not given to you. Hear me out.
That devalues, can I just say something? That devalues from the qima and the miracle of the Quran. If we're going to say, oh, it was written, that means that people can just argue and say that there was a mistake. This is dangerous. Going down that route is a very, very dangerous route.
What do you mean?
Saying that the Sahaba writ it down is a very dangerous, it's devaluing the qima and the value of the Quran.
How?
Because
according to you, that's the question.
Humans, they could have made a mistake.
No, but Allah preserved it. Allah preserved it. Allah said, that's why Allah took it upon himself. Inna nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu lahafidun. Do you know the language Arabic, Adi? Yeah, no, no. Sister. Tawkid. How many tawkids been mentioned here? How many tawkid?
I don't,
with
Quran, I don't
do
Arabic, but it's
Arabic. Arabic? I speak Arabic. Yeah, tawkid, alat tawkid. How many tawkid?
It's inna.
Inna, nahnu nazzalna dhikra wa inna lahu. لحافظون يا حافظون لحافظون. So there is many توكيد showing that this Quran Allah will preserve it, and Allah mentioned the Quran, sister, preserved. So preserved, Allah, Quran was not given to you directly, was it?
Sorry.
Quran was not given to you directly. Was it given to you directly? Prophet Muhammad was given to you, or you learned the Quran? He gave it to you straight away.
You don't need
the intermediate. No. My sister, Jamal, be truthful. Sister, where are you Egyptian? Masriya?
No, not Masriya, I'm
Maghribiya. Where you have Allah?
I lived in Masriya.
Ah, that's why. Subhanallah, but sister, be truthful. Look to you, my sister, Allah bless you. This is deen, okay?
Yeah.
You have to understand. Quran, was you had to learn Quran, correct?
Okay.
Who taught you Quran? Who teacher? Your father, your mother, al muallim?
Actually reading it.
Where did you read it?
I learned Arabic at school.
Arabic, then you learn Quran. From a Mus'haf.
Yeah.
From Mus'haf.
Yeah,
okay. So therefore, clear cut, Quran was not given to you directly. You had to learn from the Mus'haf.
No, that Mus'haf was written. I'm not talking about in an objective manner. I'm talking about in an objective manner. I'm talking about in a subjective manner.
What do you mean subjective manner?
Because this is where ilm al-ghayb comes in. Ilm al-ghayb, what you're saying is a very atheist mentality, because atheists only believe in matter, what they can see in front of them.
What were you talking about? The atheists?
The wahi. هي اللسان الذي يلحدون إليه أعجمي وهذا لسان عربي مبين.
طيب سواء.
اللسان العربي المبين the Quran is it reveals itself. So I'll give.
No wait. You quote the verse. No عفوا. What the verse means?
What is it?
The verse you just quote.
لسان الذي يلحدون إليه
أعجمي وهذا لسان عربي مبين. What does that mean?
What you're saying now is اللسان الذي تلحد إليه أعجمي and what Allah is.
No Allah said الذي يلحدون. Allah said
تلحدون. أنتم تلحدون إليه أعجمي.
No it's not about me. Allah reviewed that verse. No, sister. Allah is addressing people who accuse Prophet Muhammad alayhi salam that he's learning the Quran from a non-Arab. And Allah is refuting this argument. Yeah, because it is possible. That's why I'm saying Allah refuted the argument by saying, وَهَذَا لِسَانٌ عَرَبِيٌّ مُبِينٌ. And that is a tongue of an Arabic. You have to let me finish. You have to let me. Because this matter is not a joke, it's serious. That is an Arabic Quran. My point to you clearly, the Quran was given to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You're talking about material or not? Your Quran was not given to you directly. You didn't learn the Quran.
It can be given to a lot of people. If you put the intention that you want the Quran to be revealed to you, to know that it's the truth. Because realistically, anyone can debate. I know that the Quran is the truth. But anyone can debate the fact. You know what? These people were humans. The Sahaba made mistakes. Umar ibn Khattab himself made a mistake in front of a woman, and he said, "Asaba Umar." And he said that the women.
But sister. So one person make mistakes, but not everyone make mistakes. Allah mentioned the Quran, he will preserve the Quran, correct?
The majority of people make mistakes.
Did Allah say he preserved the Quran?
Yes, he did.
Okay, did Allah preserve the Quran or not?
He did, yes.
Did the Quran, was the Quran given to you that?
I know that the Quran is preserved. What's your proof that the Quran is preserved?
It's clear that the Quran was passed down to us generation by generation. We can go back, we have ijazat, and we can go back. The Quran that we have, like for example, that's why they say, لَا تَأْخُذُ الْقُرْآنَ عَنْ مُصْحَفِ ولا تأخذ العلم عن صحفي. You don't take knowledge from Quran from someone, some Quran who just learned it from the Mus'haf. You don't take Quran from him. Quran you have to have ijazat. And Islamically speaking, from the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, Sahaba they were pointed who knows the Quran. They used to learn from each other, then go to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and that was the case. Quran has been recited openly, and that has been the case, and we can verify that.
We can verify that
if the Muslims agree to burn all scriptures. We have nothing written.
Yeah.
Can we bring the Quran into the written form?
No, because it's
full of al-mahfuz. No. My question was
not
to you.
Because of the people, because you.
We can hafad, and are denying the truth. You're denying the truth.
So you can. I can. If a nuclear bomb comes and it wipes out the whole of the humanity, the Quran remains or
not? No, you're talking about this. Say to you. No.
Can I
if everyone's killed, bomb, Quran is not dead because everyone's killed.
No, it still remains.
No, upon the earth.
If someone dies,
isn't a preserved tablet?
You remain. Into hafid Quran, or I'm not hafid.
Yeah.
The whole humanity wipes out.
Yeah, and I'm still here, the Quran is with me.
It's Quran with you. How? If everything's
but if I memorize it.
No, do you remember memorize it.
If I memorize it, I said.
I'm not memorized.
Yeah, but he's in prison. No, but this is not this. No, my argument, my sister. No, my argument is that we can show with the reality that Quran can be preserved from human beings and they will not make mistakes. But how? We have Hufad, we can bring them right now in Algeria, Morocco, Tunisia, everywhere, in Saudi, Pakistan. We don't need of manuscripts. We don't need a Mus'haf. Quran was passed down to our generation by scholars who are experts in the Quran. Do you know how to show the Quran? Hear me, Ahmed. You have to hear me out. Show you the Quran is protected even in... Wait, before, Jamal. The Quran show you how it's been protected so precisely, even the pronunciation, even the ghunna, may, not many, is may. So even we correct you in the ghunna, which is not needed, but because that's how Prophet Muhammad recited it. Imagine we pay great attention.
So
you're digressing again. You digress. I'm showing you that we are so precise, even in ghunna, which is, even if you don't say it, there's no harm with that, but to be protected, everything has to be protected, let alone the Quran itself.
Okay, I want to go back to the case of the Prophet being the final prophet. We believe that Jesus is going to come back, sir?
As a follower, so not a prophet.
He's a prophet.
No, a follower, Prophet Muhammad.
So he's not going to be a prophet?
No, he's going to come a follower.
How are you going to know him?
He's going to come with the sifat of Isa, they can see him. For some, give us sifat.
So what's his sifat?
For sifat, he will be descended with the angels in the Damascus, in the minaret, the minar.
Okay.
So they will see him and there will be the Mahdi.
Not
me, inshallah, maybe if I'm there, alhamdulillah, it'll be good. I would like that, I love that. But I don't know when the hour will be established.
That debunks.
But sister, you ask many questions at the same time. You have to let me finish my point. My point is that Nabi described Isa to us. Isa alayhi salatu wasalam will become a follower of Prophet Muhammad.
Yeah.
The proof of that, when he will be descended, he will try to lead a prayer, or the Muslims will try to put him. They said, no, your ummah been honored. I have to follow you in a prayer. So they put a Muslim to lead Isa. He's a follower of Mustafa. So there is no more prophethood anymore.
Okay, so.
But what do you think about the verse in the Quran? It's clear.
So what about. Sorry?
Sister.
And also, Yahya alayhi salam is going to come back because he says,
Yahya where in the Quran or the prophetic narrations says Yahya will return? Because لا يجوز التقول على الله بدون علم. You cannot speak about Allah without knowledge. Our knowledge, the Quran
that's
and the Sunnah.
Does.
So you should do it as well.
Sorry.
Everyone smokes cigarette. You gonna smoke cigarette too?
No, I'm not saying that.
Forget everyone, sister. Focus on yourself.
I'm saying.
May Allah bless you.
No, I'm not saying that gives me the right to do that. I'm saying this is my understanding because I could at the end of the day I could be wrong. Like if I say that.
That's a good question. You said. I mean that's good. You said your own understanding.
Yeah.
Do you follow the Quran? Do you follow the Quran?
Yes.
The Quran said for the Muhajirin and the Ansar. Do you follow them? السابقون الأولون من المهاجرين والأنصار والذين تبعوهم بإحسان رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه وأعد لهم جنات تجري من تحتها الأنهار. In other قراءة تجري تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها. Look, we are memorizing even the other قراءات. The point here, the Quran says for the Muhajirin and the Ansar. Do you follow them? No, أخي بشوية. خليها تكلم هي.
المهاجرين والأنصار. المهاجر is the person الذي يهاجر إلى الله يهاجر إلى الحق. Okay.
No, مهاجر أنصار بالمنشن. This Muhajir Ansar, the next verse explained is the people of Medina. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the next verse mentioned, وَالَّذِينَ حَوْلَهُم مِنَ الْمَدِينَةِ, those who are surrounded by Medina. So it's talking about the Muhajir Ansar of Medina.
No,
sister, now you are making up your own things. Are you going to make up your own Quran soon? It's not a joke. But no, that's the reality, Ukhti. People of Medina and Muhajir Ansar are known. If Allah sent us to follow Muhajir Ansar, every Muhajir Ansar, I'm a Muhajir then. If you're going to follow me? If I say I'm a muhajir, are you going to follow my own understanding of the Quran? Because I'm a muhajir?
This is what, if you come here and you call people for...
So I'm muhajir.
And were you not at one point in a very bad state in life and you didn't know anything about the deen for hajart? Hajart what you were in and now you're in
So you're going to follow me?
Sorry?
You're going to follow me?
I'll follow if your truth is the truth, and that it was revealed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you're my Rasul. And
how are you Rasul? Allah, no. Allah, sister, look. Allah mentioned Muhajir Ansar. Everyone knows Muhajir Ansar. Muhajir Ansar, those who migrate from Mecca to Medina. The proof for that, sister, is in the Quran. In the Quran, Surah Al-Hashr, Surah Al-Hadid. Allah mentioned about the Muhajir and the Ansar. And he said the ayah about... where is the ayah? I forgot. I don't know what I'm in my head. Surah Al-Hadid, I think, or Surah... Because, you know, the...
Regarding Yahya, it says, Ya Yahya, خذ الكتاب بقوة وآتيناه الحكم صبية وحنانا من لدنا وزكاة وكان تقية.
سورة الحديد كم سورة الحديد؟
ولم يكن
جبارا عصيا وسلام عليه يوم ولد ويموت ويوم يبعث حيا. Yeah. So what does that mean?
That's the same ayah has been repeated with Isa, so we could say that Yahya.
No, but Isa has extra knowledge. Isa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وما قتلوه وما صلبوه ولكن رفعه الله إليه. Allah didn't say that about Yahya.
Yeah, but they both died. So
No. Allah said, وَمَا قَتَلُوهُ وَمَا صَلَبُوهُ وَلَكِنْ شُبِّهَ إِلَيْهِ. In other words, بَلْ رَفَعَهُ اللَّهُ إِلَيْهِ. Allah raised him. Allah raised him to him. So Allah mentioned extra information about Isa alayhi salatu wa salam. So Muhajir and Ansar, my sister, not what you try to define. Muhajir and Ansar. La. Where is this one? Sorry. وَمَا لَكُمْ أَلَّا تُنْفِقُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ وَلِلَّهِ مِيرَاثُ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ لَا يَسْتَوِي مِنْكُمْ مَنْ أَنْفَقَ قَبْلَ الْفَتْحِ وَقَاتَلَ أُولَئِكَ أَعْظَمُ دَرَجَةً مِنَ الَّذِينَ أَنْفَقُوا مِنْ بَعْدُ وَقَاتَلُوا وَكُلًّا وَعَدَ اللَّهُ الْحُسْنَى وَاللَّهُ بِمَا تَعْمَلُونَ خَبِيرٌ. These people Allah speaking about is the Muhajir Ansar, those who migrated before the conquest of Mecca and those who migrated and spent the sake of Allah after the conquest of Mecca. Allah said all of them in paradise. Muhajir Ansar, Al-Aus wal-Khazraj, from the people Ansar, Al-Muhajirun, those who migrated from Mecca to Medina. Sister, you are bringing your own Islam.
Can I
that's a reality.
Can I tell you
a reality.
I don't disagree that at the time there was Muhajir al-Khazraj, that was Muhajir al-Khazraj.
Khawa, you can't go back, Shriya.
No.
You come to make space.
Okay.
Come,
so you said
just do it yourself.
Minkum man anfaqa min qabli al-fatih wa qatal. I believe in the state we are in now, that Islam is not where it was at the times of the Prophet. I believe there is another fatih coming. This is my belief.
But I go and guess the verse in the Quran about inna fatahna laka fatahan mubeena. Allah already gave fatah already.
Sorry?
In the Quran, the fatah is already there.
Yeah, but when what the Prophet has taught us, it had. We need to.
No, sister, you cannot understand the Quran one verse. Sister.
I believe, according to my belief, we need another fatah.
Many people like you. You're coming with these ideas. Of
yeah, your ideas with the fatah.
Of course.
No,
so
sisters.
Sister. Allah's telling
come
us now,
like
he's speaking to the Muslim Ummah now, لا يستوي منكم من, because I believe there's another fact. So who?
But I can't get the Quran, sister. Believe whatever you like. I mean, it's haram to believe whatever you like. No, we don't say that. Astaghfirullah, let me take it back. You don't believe whatever I like. As a Muslim, you believe what Allah told you to believe.
No, I do. I can believe what I like.
That goes against
the
Quran.
No, because
Because Allah said, ادخلوا في السلم كافة. Allah called you to follow Islam.
Muslim,
well.
So you cannot believe in Christianity.
Sister,
the Islam you are following is not the Islam that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with. Now you have to understand that.
How do you know?
Because Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with Islam. I'll tell you how. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with Islam, that he's the last prophet, and there is no prophet after him. The Sahaba understood, historically speaking, that anyone claimed to be a prophet after Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he's a kadab dajjal. No doubt about that. Also, the Quran is being preserved. There is Quran.
The
Quran says Prophet is the last prophet. If someone believes there's not a prophet of Prophet, he's making a takdib of the Quran.
Okay, I didn't say.
Do you agree with that?
I didn't say Muhammad
alayhi salam.
He didn't reach the final levels of the Nubuwa, because the lot. Okay, I'll give you an example. You know, in the education system, you have a primary, you have secondary, you have college, you have university, and then you have masters, and you have a PhD. Okay, within the realm of Islam, you have the levels of the Anbiya, the Shuhada, the Sadiqeen, al Muhajireen, al Mujahideen. There's different levels because not everyone technically is going to be the same. In spirituality, there's levels.
That's why Allah says,
I was going to say that.
Okay. Just say, take care of yourself.
Sister, look, look. Sister.
The Nubuwa, the Anbiya, there's levels. So you have the level of Ibrahim.
Where in the Quran says Nubu has levels?
Because if you read the Quran until the end,
sister, look, do you understand Arabic? Look, yes, Allah faddala ba'd al-anbiya ala ba'd. No, but favored prophet of the prophet, Allah clearly said Prophet Muhammad is the seed of the prophets.
Yeah,
there's no, no, wait, there's no prophet after him. My sister, the last thing I'm going to leave you. No, sister, you go. I don't know what religion you have. The average place. That is not the religion. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the last prophet in the Quran explicitly. Clearly, Allah said, "Ma kana Muhammadun aba ahadin min rijalikum, walakin Rasulullah wa khatam al-nabiyyin." He is the seal of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. Allah said in the Quran, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورديت لكم الإسلام دينا.
That's A in the Quran.
Okay, wait. Is Islam complete? Is Islam complete?
Yes, it is.
So there's no need for prophet.
Sorry?
There's no need for prophet. Take care of yourself. May Allah bless you, my sister.
No, seriously.
Sister, this is no joke. I don't want you to die upon this belief. Because this belief is
not Islamic.
But goes with Quran, my belief.
Sorry?
Allah said, okay, is Islam complete or not? Is Islam complete or not?
Islam has always been complete.
So if it's complete, there's no more addition. It's complete.
Okay, Islam existed from the...
No, I'm asking you, is Islam complete or not? No, the verse Allah said, اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم إسلام دينا.
Allah said that, نعمة الله, نعمة محمد.
No one said, deny that. No, Prophet Sallam, you have to respect Prophet Sallam, you know?
No, he's just a human.
He's the Rasul of Allah.
He's the Prophet of Allah, yeah.
وَمَا آتَاكُمُ الرَّسُولُ وَمَا نَهَاكُمْ عَنْهُ فَانْتَهُوا. مَا كَانَ وَاللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى مَا كَانَ لِمُؤْمِنٍ وَلَا لِمُؤْمِنَةٍ إِذَا قَضَى اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ مَنْ أَمْرًا. إِذَا اللَّهُ gives a legislation,
it is
a message. No, you follow the messenger's legislation.
Habibi,
do you follow messenger's legislation, Muhammad sallallahu
alaihi
wasallam? Yeah. Where is his legislation? Where is Prophet Muhammad's kalam? Where is his speech? Where is it? Because Allah said in the Quran.
No.
Where you get that from?
Sorry?
Where you get that from?
It's known. We know it.
Look, Habibi, you want us to be guided. You don't want us just to mock her. You know, barakallahu fik. Where do you get that information? Because I don't know where you get it from. The hadith of Aisha. If you accept that, so do you accept hadith?
I do accept hadith.
Okay, and Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam, he said, Ana akhirul anbiya wa la nabiyya ba'di. I'm the last of the prophet. There is no prophet after me. And Nabi alayhi salatu wa salam said, after me, there will be 30 dajjala, kulluhum yadda'i bi annahu nabi. There will be 30 liars, or each one of them claim to be a prophet of Allah. 30, yeah. These are the main ones. 30. Yes, those are the main ones. In the language of Arabic, you can't say the number, but you can't say the number.
There's a lot of Dajjalin now who claim that.
For you, Arab. You understand Arab?
That goes against what?
No, it doesn't. Go and guess. No, it doesn't.
That means the hadith is not right.
No, it doesn't. Because the language of Arabic, the Arabs, when they mention numbers, doesn't mean the number itself. It means a lot of. It's ma'rufa. Sighat mubalagha. Hadi ma'rufa in the Arab. والله عند العرب تق الله anyway الله يهديك
may
Allah guide you yeah معروف العرب do you know العرب it's not في اللغة العربية in the حبيبي في the Arabic language sometimes they use the numbers not for the sake of the numbers for the sake of showing excessiveness no because if you know you have to understand for example now if I say I'm broke in London when I say I'm broke Bedrin what does that mean Either I'm literally broke or I don't have money.
Yeah.
But if you translate that in Arabic language and you say, أنا مكسور, you say, كيفك حبيبي, فين? قل له أنا ما عندي مال. قل له أنت تخدعني. قل له لا, أنا نتكلم هكذا عندنا في لندن. So I'm not deceiving you, that's how we speak. Yeah. So that's how, in order for you to understand the Quran, you have to understand in the language that was revealed. That's why my sister, may Allah bless you and guide you to Islam, to true Islam, then you have to understand that النبي عليه الصلاة والسلام, when he mentioned numbers sometimes, from the طريقة العرب, That doesn't mean that is the numbers.
That doesn't make sense.
To you, it makes sense to us.
It does.
Anyway, take care of yourself, my sister. May Allah bless you. Do you follow Quran? Why don't you wear hijab?
Sorry?
Why don't you wear hijab? I'm not mocking you, sister.
Yeah.
You must, inshallah, you become Muslim, inshallah, because the Islam that you have, I don't know, I'm going to make takfir, but the Islam that you have, Allah Musta'an. Why don't you wear hijab when the verse clear? What is the verse in the Quran? Ya ayyuhan nabi, qul li azwajika wa banatika wa nisa'i al-mu'minina an yudnina 'alayhinna min jalabibihinna. Do you know this ayah?
Yeah.
Do you follow it?
No.
I mean,
that's not what I understood from it.
Okay, take care of yourself. May Allah help you. Yeah, assalamu alaykum, sister. Before zinatahunna, from the Sahaba time, everyone understood jilbab in the lugha, خاصة يدنينا الدنو 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 من من الأعلى إلى الأسفل. طيب, everyone understood that. The people of the lugha Arabic understood that. العرب كلهم فهموا هذا. أنت أختي, after 14 years, 100 years ago in speakers corner, you understood. No, sister, look, the hellfire and paradise belong to Allah.
Okay, so
but one say to you, but you have to know. Hijab is
hijab is
no. What I'm showing you, sister. No, sister.
I've already done a debate about hijab.
No, what, sister. What I'm showing you, you're not following the Quran.
Sorry.
You don't understand the Quran correctly. May Allah help you, anyway. I'm sorry if I said something to disrespect you.
You can't say that. You can't say that I'm not following the Quran.
But Quran. Okay. If someone says.
That's your understanding of the ayahs of the hijab.
Okay. If someone says Isa ibn Allah,
yeah.
Is he following the Quran or going against the Quran?
We need to understand what he means by son of God.
Take care of yourself. Salam alaikum. Assalamu alaikum. May Allah help you, sister. Look, sister, we're not trying to mock you because a lot of us here, but go home and take this matter serious, you know? Wallahi, sister, because we don't want you to go home thinking out there mocking us. This matter is serious.
It's because I like to stimulate my mind to anything that I don't know. I don't
know. No, your mind.
But this is where we need to let our ego. We need to let go of our ego and then say, you know what? I might be wrong as well because you might.
No,
be
I'm not. I'm not.
You,
Abadan.
Everyone
never.
Can be wrong.
So, are you wrong about Allah is one?
Sorry.
Are you wrong about Allah is one?
No, because I witnessed that Allah is one.
Khalas. So I'm not wrong. I've witnessed the Quran where it says clearly. So I'm not wrong.
So you witnessed that the Quran is the haq.
No, that's about that. No.